Humanity is running on full power, from indoor plumbing to the lights on our houses to our cars, devices. We're an energized society. In a world where people live in fear of running out of energy, a team of unique researchers have found a potentially infinite power source. Meet Dr. Lenny Tender. He is a research chemist at the Naval Research Laboratory. He's a principal investigator behind the benthic microbial fuel cell.
The benthic microbial fuel cell is a device that extracts electricity from the seafloor, and it's being developed to persistently operate oceanographic sensors. Nearly all scientific sensors that go into the marine environment are battery powered. So what the benthic microbial fuel cell does is it actually draws electricity out of the bottom of the seafloor. That's what benthic means. It's the interface between the sediment on the bottom of a marine environment and the overlying water. And it's able to generate electricity just like a windmill. It's an energy harvester. And the sediment has actually quite a bit of fuel in it. You can think of anything that's ever lived in the marine environment, phytoplankton, sea creatures, etc. When they die, they wind up settling down on the seafloor. It's just like leaves on your lawn. Those creatures, as they start decomposing, that represents a pretty potent fuel source, glucose, for example. And that is the geological precursor for petroleum. And it's just sort of sitting there mixed into the sediment on the seafloor. That's a very useful fuel. And what I mean by as a fuel is something that a microorganism can use to acquire energy from. And it's also something that we can use to acquire energy from to operate marine devices.
Future energy sources could come from some pretty unlikely places, like wastewater, for example.
The treatment of wastewater conventionally requires a lot of energy. And we're right next door to a massive wastewater treatment facility, and it consumes 36 megawatts of electricity to treat that wastewater. But the inherent energy represented by the organic matter, which is the fuel in the wastewater, can be used to generate electricity. So there's an opportunity to flip that equation upside down and to actually think of wastewater treatment plants as power stations generating power.
And why stop at wastewater? Dr. Tender says that there's a potential to take this energy utilizer to the skies.
We actually have organisms that we've isolated from the benthic microbial fuel, so they're very good at accepting electrons from electrodes and reducing carbon dioxide. So now we have to get them to take the reduced carbon dioxide and make a fuel. So what does that mean? So you could actually have a large facility that would essentially suck the carbon dioxide out of the air. And at the end of it, you might have a valve, and out would come a fuel that you can operate your car. All the fuel that we're getting now that we, the petroleum-based fuel, we're pumping it out of the ground. And, it's all the carbon has been sequestered underground, and then we burn it, and we're dumping more carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. This is an opportunity to start drawing on the carbon dioxide that's already in the atmosphere, and then sucking it out, and then generating a fuel.
NRL Science, solving the challenges of tomorrow.